Nous consommons des matières premières.
So we use raw materials, we accumulate goods, we recycle our waste. When we analyze the link between all these factors in a growing economy, we can define three requirements for a sustainable economy. First, to
en gros, inférieur
accumulate
à 20%
additional
de consommation nouvelle de matières premières,
new products, new goods, which is 20% below our consumption of raw materials. So it means that we have to produce 20% waste in proportion of the quantities we produce. We have to recycle. We have to produce a lot of waste. We have to recycle 60 to 80% of the waste
enfin,
we produce.
Cardinale,
and finally, the pivotal condition is that the growth rate for this raw material needs to be below 1% per year, i.e. below the growth rate, the economic growth rate we wish to have to justify investment and maintain jobs. If we present this on a typical graph for circular economy with a non-renewable material that we extract from deposits and that we use and that we add to our inventories, our stocks, our goods, our factories, our houses, part of which that we discard, which can be either dumped into waste fields, all that we recycle. If we look at the graph as represented here, we see that this is absolutely not sustainable. Why? Because first and foremost, we have too high a growth rate, and for each cycle, the new requirements are much higher because time is spent when we were using raw materials extracted 20 years ago, and new requirements are much higher. So the part that we reintroduce in the system come from our consumption of the past, and that's not sufficient to face our requirements. So we have too high growth, we add too much to stocks. That's the blue arrow going to the facing down, and we produce too small a quantity of waste, which might sound paradoxical, but the share of waste that's being recycled is not sufficient. So we have a simulation of circular economy, but the recycling effort is never going to help us slow down raw material consumption and gain time with regards to the depletion of resources. Now, if we take a look at the same type of pattern that would be used to an almost circular growth, in such a case, we have a growth of consumption below 1% per year, so for each cycle, the needs of today are slightly above, but not very much above, the needs of 10 years ago, which is the period of time in which the material stayed in the economy, so that the consumption time that our economy is built upon at the moment, so not too big a growth, small addition to stocks, so that the material that we use come to replace material that we discard, and we accumulate slightly, but not a lot, less than 20%. And then, so it means that we also produce a lot of waste, and what exits the economy is almost as important as the input in an economy, and that's essential in an economy. It's essential in a biosystem in which the ecological chain is based on various steps of waste. So we need to send to waste quite a lot, and we also need to recycle massively, more than 60 to 80% of all quantities sent to waste. And this recycle cycle can meet our new requirements, and we know that if we were capable of observing the three prerequisites, one, do not accumulate too much through our new consumption, then recycle everything we sent to waste, and recycle a lot as compared to what we consume and grow our needs very slightly as compared to the growth rate that we're looking for at the moment. If we meet the three requirements, we are going to shift the depletion graph from raw materials and the accumulated impact of these raw materials for the decades to come, that is, impact on CO2, on waters, etc. So it's by putting together the three requirements that we can have a sustainable and economic growth approach.